Okay, we're going to talk about counting 16th note figures in music using the 1E and a 2E and a system. All right. I'm just going to review a little bit. Using a simple meter, a 4-4 time, which is four beats in the measure and the quarter note gets one count. Each quarter note would receive the beat, so you'd have four of these in a measure. All right. Of course, a measure is a unit of time in music, and the time signature tells me some important information. In this case, it's called simple time. The top number is either 2, 3, or 4. Bottom number, that tells me how many beats in the measure. The bottom number is the secret code telling me what is going to get the beat. 4 means quarter note. All right. If I split these quarter notes into two equal parts, you'd have 2/8 notes, and we would count these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Each one of these gets a beat. It covers the same amount of time or space in music as a quarter note. And that'd be, this is half, so 1. This is the second half of the beat. All right, so if the beat is this much time in music, then this is how much time the eighth notes take up. 1. All right. Now, what we're going to talk about today, though, is splitting up those quarter notes. I mean, into 16th notes. Splitting up those quarter notes into 16th notes. All right. So a quarter note gets a beat, an eighth note gets a half a beat. So that would take 2/8 notes to make one beat in 4/4 time, or 3/4 time, or 2/4 time. The 4 means the quarter note is what gets the beat. So the eighth note is going to get half of a beat. Now to further split this note up, divide this note up, we would divide up eighth notes divided up evenly would result in 16th notes. All right, so it takes 2 16th notes to equal the same amount of time or space as an eighth note. So one beat would involve 4 16th notes, and we would count this 1 E and A. All right, or that's the first beat. Of course, the second beat would be 2 E and A. Third beat would be 3 E and A, 4 E and A, 5, right? 5 E and A, or it wouldn't be 5. You can't have 5/4. You can have 5/4, but anyway. All right, so 1 E and A. Now, there are a lot of different ways to utilize 16th notes in conjunction with eighth notes to create different little syncopated rhythms using 16th notes on the beat. And I'm going to give you a whole list of them right now. And a lot of the music I've been writing for my students, if you're watching this, you're probably one of my students, has different versions or different arrangements of these 16th notes. Sorry. So the first thing I'm going to do is put up 2/8 notes like this. All right. And then I'm going to break it down with 16th notes, all the different variations of 16th notes and 8th notes. All right. All right. Of course, the first one is 4 16th notes, 1 E and A. This is 1 and, well, I'm just going to make believe this is all the first beat of the measure. 1 and, this would be 1 E, which is equal to the first eighth note. And this is and, which is the beginning of the second eighth note. And then the second half of that eighth note is a. So 1 E, these 2 16th notes covers the same amount of ground or space as this first eighth note. And then it covers the same amount of space as that eighth note, the and of one, we call it. That's what we say. So the and of one, that means the second half of the first beat. If I said the and of two, that means the second half of the second beat, the and of two. This is the and of one. Are 2 16th notes that cover the same amount of time as this eighth note. All right. Now another real common arrangement of eighth note, 16th note is eighth, and then 2 16ths. So this would be one, the E is right in here, and this would be 1 and 2 and 3 and, if you've heard that, people being silly, go 1 and 2 and 1, that's the rhythm, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. The other one is also very common, is 2 16ths notes at the beginning, and then the and right here. So that would be 1 E and. So if I were counting this, I'd go 1 E and 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 That's 1/4 time. One beat in the measure. One and a one and a one knee and. One and a two and a three and a four. That's that rhythm. Da, 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 da. This rhythm is da, 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 da. Okay? All right. Now, further, another variation of 16th notes is one, Now this is, here's the eighth notes, right in here, here's one and, so this is one, and right in here, this whole space here is the E and right in here. So the E and is covered here, this dotted eighth note, covers the same amount of territory as these three, one, E and. If I tied these together like this, it would sound like this. One, a two, a three, a four. One, a two, a three, a four. A one, a two, a three, a four. That's a dotted eighth, 16th. A really common rhythm in music. Da, da, da. The other one is exactly the opposite. It's a 16th note connected to a dotted eighth note. There. That's the flip side of it. Instead of one, a two, a three, a four, this is one E, two E, three E, four E. This is the 16th note. There's a 16th. One E and a two E and a three E and a four. One E, two E, three E, four E. Ba ba, ba ba, ba ba, ba ba. That's the 16th dotted eighth. All right, so that's one E. Not a very good E. One E. All right, one E. The other little version, not quite as common, but you find it, and it's pretty cool little syncopated rhythm, is a 16th, eighth note, 16th, all right? So that's, here's one. This is E and a. One E, a two E, a three E. So one E, the and is right in there, but we got that's an eighth note, which covers the same amount of ground as two 16th notes, right? An eighth note is equal to the same amount of distance or time as two 16th notes. So this is one E, a two E, a one, you know, like one E, a two E, one E, a two E, a three E, a four E, a one E, a two E, one E. That's how you count it. One E, Oh boy, one E. It's like a blob of red. One E. One E, a two E, all right? All right, so these are your most common in all the variations of 16th notes and eighth notes put together to make a beat, to cover one beat or one quarter note. All right, and this is all in simple time, either in 4/4 time, 3/4, 3/4 time, 4/4 time, 2/4 time, or some irregular meters like 5/4, 7/4 time, wherever the 4 is at the bottom. The quarter note is getting the beat. Wherever the quarter note is getting the beat, you'll find these rhythms. All right, they're very common. All right, so let's do a little practice. Now let's do a little practice, okay? Beep, 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 beep. High tech. It's on a music stand. You're just whipping this thing around with a music stand, right? All right. So let's count. Let's practice counting this rhythm right here. You be figuring it out while I'm putting it up here, and we'll count it together in just a second. We're gonna pretend we're in 3/4 time, okay? We're in 3/4 time, all right? And how would I count this? Well, it would be one and two E and three One and a two E and three one. That's how you count that. One and a two, one and a two E and three one and a two E and three All right, let's do another one. I could actually erase this, I guess. Can I erase this? I can erase this, can I? Okay, good. Can you remember all that right there? All right, so I can make it 4/4 time now. 4/4 time, all right. So, okay, Have you figured this one out while I was writing it? All right. So we got 1 and 2 E, 3 E and 4 E. 1 and 2 E, 3 E and 4 E. So you count that. 1 and 2 E, 3 E and 4 E. So you count that one. 1. Here's the E and 2 E and 2 E, 3 E and 4 E. That's equal to E and it's a dotted eighth note. Notice that the little 16th note line right here is on this side, touching that. It's affecting this note right here. So that's a 16th note, and that's a dotted eighth note. Right. We could write it this way, 16th note, and then a dotted eighth. In fact, in the old days, that's how they would have written it. But in more modern times, we beam these notes together. All right, we beam them, all right, so let's do another one. This is actually one of the guitar songs I just handed out one of my students. Okay, you got that figured out? Got that figured out? 1 E and, it's 2 16th notes and then an eighth note. 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 and 4 4 the E and, 4 E and, 4 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 and 4 1 E and, let's count together. Ready and count. 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 and 4 1 E and, 2 E and, 3 and 4 How that one goes. Alright, let's do another one. Let's do it in 3/4 time. 3/4 time. Alright, 3/4 time. Okay, got this figured out? Can you see that all right? All right, so 1, 2, I put 4/4. This is silly. Here we go, ready and count. 1, 2, 3, 3E. That's how you count that. 1 E and 2 E and 3 E and E and is right in here. E and it covers that whole ground. Yeah, it's a little arrow there. 3 E and 3 E 1 2 3 E Alright. Let's do one more. How long have we been going on this thing? We've been going 13 minutes. Oh wow. All right, 4/4 time. Might as well keep it in 4/4 since I'll probably write it in 4/4 anyway. All right. Da 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 da. Okay. All right. Let's count this. Ready and count. 1 and 2 E and 3 E 4 E 1 and 2 E and 3 E 4 E All right, you got this. This is pretty simple. We already figured that 1 is the eighth note. And here's the second half of the beat. 1. Here's the quarter and eighth notes all in. All not in. Where they land. 1 and 2 and 3. The ends right in here someplace. 4, the and is right in here someplace. Right. So here's 1 and 2 E and 3 E. 4 E. Because the E and is right in here. This covers the E and the A, the beginning of and here's the second, the very last 16th note of the beat. That's the very last 16th note of that fourth beat. For E, all of this is the fourth beat. All of this is the third beat. All of this is the second beat. All of this is the first beat. So every beat in simple time, where the quarter note gets the beat, every beat is going to be equal to 4/16th notes. They're either going to be combined into eighth notes, or they're going to be, you know, all 16th notes, or they might even be all put together, which would be a quarter note. 4/16th notes all looped together so that they have a continuous sound is a quarter note. 2/16th notes, if you put them together, if you link them together, it's equal to two eighth notes. But if you split those eighth notes up, then you get 4/16th notes, just like we've got here. Okay. All right. I hope that helps. And of course, you can contact me through Facebook on my Dan Cutchen Music page if you have any questions. All right. Thanks.